I'm going to use the TI-84 to find those sum of squared error, the difference between the observed value and the predicted value squared. And I'm using that tattoos and teeth data set that I've been working with on my previous examples. Unfortunately, when you run a linear regression in the TI-84, it won't give it in its output, so you have to create a couple of different columns to help find it if you don't want to do this by hand. So going to my stat menu, I'm going to right arrow, actually, sorry about that, I'm going to stay on my edit menu. And again, my first list is the number of tattoos, my second list is the number of teeth. So what I want to do is I want to scroll over to list three, up arrow so that list three is highlighted and push enter. And you'll see it moves the cursor down to the bottom of your screen. So there I can put in an expression. And I'm going to do this in a couple of steps. I'm going to do create a column for list three and create the squared values in list four and then find the sum for list four. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to need to get the predicted values. The regression equation for this problem was, and I'm going to round to two decimal places, was 30.62 minus 0.80 times the number of teeth. So I can go ahead and put that in, and that way the calculator will do all of those predicted values for me, minus 0.80, and I want to multiply that by list one. That's my input variable or my predictor variable. Okay, so there's the regression equation. Pressing enter, I have all of my predicted values. So here are my predicted values here. I'm sorry, here are my observed values. Here are my predicted values. Now, what I want to do is I want to use list four to find the difference between these two and then square that difference. So again, if I right arrow and then up arrow to list four so that it's highlighted and then push enter, it'll move my cursor down to the bottom of the screen and I can input an expression rather than having to do that all by hand. So I'm going to open up a set of parentheses and it's going to be my observed values, those are in list two, minus my predicted values, which are in list three. Close my parentheses and then I need to square those values. So I pushed on or clicked on my x squared key and then enter. And then you'll see those differences squared in the fourth column. Now I need to get the sum of this fourth column. To get a sum, you want to go back to your stat menu, right arrow over to calc, and it's in your first option, the same place where we went to when we were finding the mean and standard deviation. After pressing enter, you need to tell it what list your data is in. I have those values in list four, so I needed to change that. Down arrow to calculate. And you'll see the second value is the sum of those values in that column, sigma x. Okay, so since we told it what list we were working with, it's going to sum up all of those values in that list. And due to rounding, it's a little bit different than what I got in my example when I used Minitab Express, and that's okay. Okay, I wanted to show you that if you're given a regression equation and the slope and intercept term are rounded, you can go ahead and put that in to your calculator and use that instead to find the predicted values.